Blackhawks and Oilers played the first game of the 2020 NHL playoffs in Edmonton. It's game one of a best of five series. I'll now turn it over to Doc Emmerich and the guys at NBC for the call.
Line over the Rangers saw a lot of intensity and some hitting in the very early stretches. These are different teams. This is a different place. We will see if that happens. Has Nugent Hopkins over on this side, and that's where the pass comes. Nugent Hopkins moving back in. Just holds there and laid it on back. Klefbom with a walk across. Has McDavid there. At the front is Chiasson. McDavid led it on back. Klefbom there. It's sent over to Nugent Hopkins. His shot! Score! A power play goal for the Oilers. They strike first.
Well, the puck movement of the Edmonton Oilers. Moving the puck from one side of the ice to the other. McDavid started over on the right side. He worked himself over there. 97 in orange. Gets this puck. The screen in front of the net from Chiasson, and McDavid goes short side high on Corey Crawford.
There's a little bit of Wayne Gretzky in that one, Enzo and Doc. You watch McDavid, he comes outside the blue line to attack with a little bit more speed and create some separation, and that's just launched.
Again, Nylander came by, came right out in front. Oh, and a chance for Kane would not go. There was the equalizer on his stick. Played around behind, trying to send. They score! A big shot from behind, and the game is tied! Strom, and it's 1-1.
Well, a quality chance for Patrick Kane right prior to the goal, but what a headsy play here from Ryan Strom. The giveaway by Klefbom initially with the chance for Kane. And then Mike Smith, we talked about his puck handling abilities. He thinks somebody's there, but then right off the backside of Smith into the back of the net.
Heady play is right. And that's another one, Alan Gretzky. Shoot it off the backside of the goalie after he has an egregious turnover. Great play by Dylan Strom.
That ricocheted, though, off of Nugent Hopkins and can be taken by Keith and handed on to Kane again. Here's Kane shuffling it along. Puck came back over to Kubalik, let one out in front. Score! It's Taves, and a power play goal.
And he talked about outworking people. Chicago Blackhawks outworked the Edmonton Oilers right there, no question about it. And the puck comes to Jonathan Taves in the back door. He corrals a rolling puck and puts it up and over Mike Smith. But watch the Chicago Blackhawks. They want that puck. They mount a man, Edmonton, at the point of attack. Taves gets it on the backside. You see, the puck is on edge, so he can elevate it a little bit easier. And he blows it by Mike Smith.
What a pass by Dominic Kubalik.
You see, the pace is very good, and the puck movement's getting better.
Score! The Blackhawks on a tip shot have now made it 3-1. Brandon Saad may have been the last to touch a toss from the point that was directed home. And so the Blackhawks have gotten three of the first four goals of the game.
Well, win a faceoff. Create an opportunity. The quick shot from the point, and yes, Doc, the high redirect from Brandon Saad about 8 or 10 feet out in front of Mike Smith. 20 in white, hits it, and it skips right past Mike Smith. No chance for him. The Blackhawks, they have been the better team without question at 5-on-5. It hasn't even been.
David Eddie.
Taves bearing down. McDavid emerged with that. Got tangled up around behind, though. Swept out in front. Score! The Blackhawks again and again. It's Jonathan Taves, and it is 4-1.
I know Dave Tippett doesn't want to use his timeout. You only get one of them. But you got to be thinking about slowing this game down. It's 4-1 already. A turnover by McDavid. He's going to get this puck, but watch the stick of Brandon Saad. Right there. He turns it over. The Hawks win. Support by Kubalik, and a no chance for Mike Smith. Just absolute domination by the Chicago Blackhawks here this afternoon. They've got four in the first 13 minutes of this qualifier.
Yeah, that man's got three. He's got two.
Chase on tries again. A little feed out in front. Stumbling down to the ice, Nugent Hopkins. Onto the back. It is played back in and walked on now by McDavid. Shuffled one that popped over to Keith. Fender cross. Oh, and a great stop by Crawford. Sprawling play made at the front of the net. How did that ever stay out? Fed in front again. Score! The Oilers connect on the power play. Dreisaitl.
Now, the urgency is clearly apparent for the Edmonton Oilers. They didn't get the memo about starting the game on time, but they started the second period a lot better. Leon Draisaitl is going to be the goal scorer. At one end, you got the save. Rashad going hard to the net. Usually that leads to a chance at the other end. And that's exactly what Edmonton will do. They'll go up and down the ice, get it in deep, and eventually Leon Draisaitl will capitalize off of this skirmish. You see how Nugent Hopkins is active, and there's Draisaitl right in the slot.
Who scored earlier, Patrick Kane, who hasn't scored yet. Until this shot goes in by Kubalik as the power play began. 5-2 Blackhawks as you hear the United Center horn and song.
This all starts again off of a face-off win by Jonathan Toews. Good help from Kirby Dach. Duncan Keith gets it, puts it in the wheelhouse of Dominic Kubalik, and he just hammers this puck short side. Don't know if Smith got a piece of it, but awfully deep in his net, lots of room up top. And now it looks like we're going to have a goaltending change.
The Islanders. Kane with a shot fought off by Koskinen. Said in the middle of the summer, before we got into August now, that a number 12 seed could win this thing. Kane a shot. Oh, and Duncan Keith rattled one that becomes the sixth goal of the game for the Blackhawks. Kubalik on the deflection, and so it becomes 6-2 Chicago.
A great job by Duncan Keith. Take that relay from Toews. Pile drive it on goal right off of Dominic Kubalik in the slot. Keith doesn't waste any time at all. He's got time. He's got space. And watch it change direction right there off of Kubalik to make it 6-2. The power play for the Hawks is electrifying. Eddie, you talked about it in their pre-tournament game. They had two goals against St. Louis, and it's seated up here today in Edmonton.
Behind it is James Neal out there now. Onto the back. It comes back over to McDavid. McDavid fed one around in front. The jam play by Neal. The rebound. Oh, and McDavid couldn't jam it. Home scramble there. They score. It is James Neal out of the net now. Scramble to make it 6-3.
Well, Doc talked about James Neal being on the power play. A little change up here for the Edmonton Oilers. James Neal down low playing the role of Alex Chiasson. He's going to get it off the post the first time. Doesn't go in. McDavid can't get it to go, but Neal will bat away at it. Crawford couldn't find it. Eventually, it finds its way to the back of the net. That's off the post, and here comes James Neal to clean up the loose change. 6-3 Chicago.
Gibson Dreisaitl on this faceoff. Scott Cherry dropped it. Puck came to the back. Cleft bomb there, and a shot. Score! And it's 6-4.
During the TV timeout, Dave Tippett brought his guys around. He had the dry erase board out. He said, we're pulling the goalie, we're going for it. And so far, it's worked pretty well. Toews hasn't lost a lot of draws. He loses that one. Puck comes straight back, shot on goal, little deflection in front. I don't know if James...
But no two-point play here. A marvelous performance from the team. But you point to individuals offensively and also the goaltender who came in. Played a few minutes on Wednesday, played the whole game today, and his team goes up 1-0 in the best of five.